Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. So, how are you guys? Okay, today we are going to study about inheritance, okay? So, let's begin. Okay, before you want to study about inheritance, okay, you should know a few terms, okay, that you will always use, okay, while studying about inheritance. Okay, so the first one, you should know what does gene and allele means. Okay, so let's go one by one. So gene is a basic unit of inheritance which consists of DNA segment located at a specific locus of chromosome. Okay, so this is a pair of homologous chromosome. Okay, so this is a pair of homologous chromosome. So this is one chromosome, this is another one chromosome. Sebab dia cakap pair, pair tu maksudnya dua, satu, dua. Okay, and then it say homologous chromosome. Homologous chromosome means that homologous, that chromosome that has, that is identical. Okay, so they have the same height, the same characteristic. Okay, that's mean by homologous. Homo means the same. Okay, so where can you find gene? Okay, in the chromosome. So this is gene, and this is gene. Okay, so gene is located, okay, in the same locus. Locus tu maksudnya adalah kedudukan dia. Awak tengok, locus ni dengan locus ni. So genes, okay, is located at a specific locus. Locus tu maksudnya position dia lah. Dekat mana? Dekat chromosome. Okay, a gene control a specific characteristic of organism. For example, this gene that located in this locus, okay, dia carry information pasal skin color. Contoh, okay, kalau locus ni, okay, gene tu menyimpan karakteristik, contohnya warna mata. Can you understand? So every locus contain gene that store different information. Okay, can you understand about gene? The next one is allele. Okay, what is allele? Okay, an allele is a alternative form of gene for a specific trait. Okay, that is located on the same locus of the pair of chromosome. Okay, so sekarang ni, if you notice here, this is gene, right? Okay, this is gene. This is gene. Why? Because they are located in the same locus. So, allele tu apa ni? Allele tu yang ada dalam each gene tu. Okay, so pertama sekali kita ada allele T besar. Seterusnya kita ada allele T kecil. So, yang satu ni kita namakan sebagai allele. Ni allele satu, ni allele dua. Can you understand? Okay. Sebab tu dia cakap is located on the same locus. So locus yang samalah. Okay. Okay, the next one you should know about characteristic. Okay, and also trait. Apa beza dua ni? Okay, characteristic ni is a characteristic is a heritable feature such as height, okay, eye color, blood and so on. Okay, it is a characteristic of feature of organism. While trait, trait is a variation of a specific characteristic. Sebagai contoh, if your characteristic tu is about height, so trait ni ada dua possibility, sama ada awak tall ataupun dwarf. Okay, sama ada awak tinggi ataupun awak dwarf ni apa? Bukan terencat, apa? Pendek lah, macam tu lah. Okay, kalau characteristic color, okay, apa warna dia? Red ataupun white. Kalau blood blood group, okay, blood darah A, blood darah B, blood darah AB dan O. Okay, can you distinguish between characteristic and trait? Okay, I give you another example. For example, size, sebagai contoh. Kalau characteristic dia size, trait dia big ataupun small. Okay, okay, boleh faham eh? Okay, the next one, okay, the last one which is about phenotype and genotype. Okay, phenotype ni apa? Phenotype is the observable characteristic of an organism. Example, hi. Okay, phenotype ni is the one, is a characteristic yang awak boleh tengok dengan mata. Sebagai contoh, awak tengok dia tinggi. Ha, so, itu adalah phenotype dia. Kalau awak tengok dia kulit gelap, itulah phenotype dia. Okay, kalau genotype, okay, genotype is a genetic composition of organism that cannot be seen. Ha, genotype nama lagi gen, gene is something that you cannot see. Okay, so genotype ni, it is written as T besar, T besar ataupun T besar, T kecil ataupun T kecil, T kecil. So if you notice, in order to write genotype, you should write the allele. So remember allele yang cikgu sebut tadi, T besar, T kecil. So this is allele 1, this is allele 2. In order to form genotype, you should have at least 2 allele. So ni ada 2 allele lah. Allele T besar, allele T besar. Yang ni allele T besar, allele T kecil. So dua-dua ni kita namakan sebagai gene. So genotype. Ni gene lah kan, betul tak? Satu ni allele, okay? So this is how you write it. Okay, so example here, okay, awak tengok eh. Okay, contohlah kita punya characteristic height. Okay, boleh faham? Trait dia sama ada tinggi ataupun rendah. So genotype untuk tinggi ni, okay, ada dua possibility. Sama ada dia T besar, T besar ataupun T besar, T kecil. Okay, so phenotype dia tinggilah. Ini yang apa awak nampak. Okay, kalau rendah pula, dia mesti terkecil-terkecil. Okay, so phenotype dia benda yang awak nampak apa, dia kecil betul tak? Okay, so cikgu macam mana nak bezakan T-besar, T-besar, kenapa T-besar, T-besar dan T-besar, T-kecil ni boleh jadi tinggi? Kenapa T-kecil, T-kecil ni jadi rendah? Okay, nanti kita akan belajar next page. Okay, so far so good eh. Okay, the next one. Okay, yang ni kita akan belajar in detail lah yang pasal tadi. Okay, seterusnya you are going to study about allele. Pasal tak tadi allele yang cikgu cerita tadi, allele yang satu-satu tu kan. Okay, allele ni it has two types. Okay, it could be dominant ataupun recessive. Okay, kalau dominant allele, dia mesti capital letter. Macam tadi kita guna T besar, betul tak? So, T besar is a dominant allele. Tapi kat sini example dia B besar lah. Okay, kalau recessive tukar je lah. Okay, mesti small letter. Okay, boleh faham? Okay, so dominant allele is allele which always show its trait when it is present. Okay, and suppress, okay, the effect of recessive allele. Okay, recessive allele is an allele which show a trait when both allele is recessive allele and the effect of recessive allele is suppressed by the presence of dominant allele. Okay, yang ni kita go explain yang kat bawah ni. Okay, so untuk this one, okay, so sekarang ni kan awak dah ada T besar, awak dah tahu eh, kalau T besar it is dominant allele. Kalau T kecil dia adalah recessive allele. So sekarang ni macam kita belajar tadi, dekat slide ni. Okay, awak tengok eh. Ni, okay, cikgu besarkan. Okay, satu ni adalah dominant allele. So dua ni, ni pun dominant allele. So bila kita ada dua benda yang sama, okay, dua benda yang sama, okay, kita namakan dia sebagai homozygous dominant. B besar, B besar ni. Awak tengok ni. Yang ni adalah dominant allele. Yang ni dominant allele. Dia sama. So dia homo lah. Sebab homo kan. So this thing, okay, we can say it is homozygous dominant. Kalau yang ni pun homozygous dominant ke cikgu? Tak. Sebab apa? Ini homozygous juga sebab dia sama kan. Tapi awak kena tambah recessive. Sebab apa recessive? Sebab B kecil dan B kecil adalah allele, recessive allele. Okay, kalau heterozygous ada satu saja, dia mesti satu besar satu kecil. Okay, satu besar satu kecil. Tapi awak kena ingat, okay, so kalau B besar, B besar, maksudnya dia ada dua-dua dominant allele. Okay, bila dua-dua ada dominant allele, for sure dia akan B ni apa? Okay, tak apalah. Sebagai contohlah B ni untuk besar lah. B ni untuk besar. So maksudnya dia punya phenotype dia mesti akan besar. Okay, besar lawan dia apa? Kecil, betul tak? So sebab dia ada dua-dua B kecil, so maksudnya dia akan jadi kecil lah. Okey, tapi kalau kat sini, kalau awak tengok heterozygous, dia lebih besar, lebih kecil. Ingat eh, dominant allele will always be dominant. So maksudnya dia akan tutup B kecil ni. So dia punya phenotype dia besar ke kecil? Akan jadi besar. Sebab apa besar? Sebab it has dominant allele. Instead awak tengok kat, in fact awak tengok eh, dekat sini cakap dominant allele always show and when it is present. Maksudnya kalau ada dominant allele, dominant allele tu yang akan sentiasa ditunjukkan berbanding recessive allele. Recessive allele tu dia akan di express, dia akan tunjuk bila dia ada dua-dua. Kalau dia ada satu dia tak boleh. Dominant allele akan lagi kuat. Okay. Okay guys, so the next one, tadi kita belajar dominant allele and recessive allele. Next one is dominant trait and recessive trait. Okay, so dominant trait tu maksudnya yang kuat lah. Kalau recessive tu yang lemah. Okay, apa contoh dia? Okay, kejap saya tunjuk kat sini. Okay, tadi kita belajar pasal trait kan? Ni trait ni. So sekarang ni, trait dominant, trait recessive. So tall ni, trait dominant. Kalau dwarf ni adalah trait recessive. Sebab apa? Dia ada dominant allele. Lepas ni ada recessive allele. Okay. Okay, so this one done. Okay, the just next one. Okay, parental generation and filial generation. Okay, parental generation refer to the first generation of two individual which are made, okay, to predict and analyze the genotype of their offspring. Okay, yang ni straightforward information, nanti kita belajar lagi. Filial generation refer to the successive okay, generation as the result of mating between individual of purebred parental generation. Purebred tu maksudnya dia ambil daripada sperm and ovum daripada parents lah. Okay, so ini maksudnya offspring dia lah. Okay, purebreds and hybrid. Apa maksud dia ni? Purebreds refer to individual which carry two identical allele for a trait. Okay, purebred tu maksudnya kita guna two identical allele. Okay, allele tu mesti dia mesti besar ataupun mesti kecil, betul tak? Kalau identical maksudnya kita kena kacut ataupun kita kena mix, kita kena cross, kita kena gabungkan. T besar, okay, kita gabungkan dengan T kecil. Itu maksud two identical. Identical tu sama allele dia. Okay, self cross always produce offspring with the same characteristic in every generation. Okay, tak apa. Yang ni kita belajar je lagi. And hybrid is a produce is the product of mating between two purebred variety. So lepas kita hasilkan purebred, okey, anak-anak dia tu kita kacukkan, dan bila kita kacukkan anak-anak dia tu, nama dia adalah hybrid lah. Okey. Okey, so sekarang ni cikgu nak cerita pasal monohybrid. Okey, monohybrid inheritance. Monohybrid inheritance maksudnya kita hanya cerita pasal satu saja karakteristik. Okey, kalau kat sini karakteristik dia adalah warna, betul tak? Sebab apa? Kita punya trait adalah purple dan juga white. Purple and white ni they are known as a trait. Ingat lagi tak cikgu cerita tadi? Mula-mula karakteristik kan? Karakteristik contohnya height. Kalau trait dia sama ada tall ataupun short, betul tak? Tapi kalau kat sini, kalau diagram kat sini, they use karakteristik dia adalah color. So trait kita adalah apa? Trait kita adalah purple and white. Okay, so kalau awak perasan dekat sini, this is monohybrid. Okay, ni monohybrid. Kenapa monohybrid? Mono means satu. Satu saja karakteristik yang kita nak bincang. Apa karakteristik kita? Karakteristik kita adalah color. Boleh faham? Okay, monohybrid cross. So this is what we call monohybrid. Okay. Satu lagi, yang ni pun dinamakan sebagai purebred. Sebab apa purebred? Sebab tadi awak tengok purebred. Apa maksud purebred? Refer to identical individual which carry two identical allele. Two identical allele maksudnya allele dia tu sama dua-dua. Allele dia sama dua-dua. So, ini allele yang pertama. Ni allele yang kedua. So, sama tak? Samalah.
Yang ni allele yang pertama, ni allele kedua. Sama tak sama kan? Sebab dia berkecik-berkecik. So itu maksudnya pure breed. So ini adalah monohybrid dan juga pure breed. Okay. So this is how you sketch the, this is what we call monohybrid. Monohybrid sebab apa? Sebab kita kacukkan dan kita study satu karakteristik saja. Dan the whole thing here is known as a schematic diagram. Benda ni, the whole thing here is known as a schematic diagram. Okay, so pertama sekali, sekejap ada lori lalu depan macam ni. Sibuk je nak belajar bahari juga. Okay, so this is how you sketch schematic diagram. So apa info yang dia bagi? So pertama sekali dia cakap parental phenotype. Mestilah parental sebab apa? We comes from the parent. Betul tak? Kita datang daripada mak dan ayah. So phenotype, mesti tulis phenotype dulu. Phenotype tu is a physical characteristic yang awak boleh nampak. Apa yang awak boleh nampak? Dia warna purple dan dia juga warna putih. Boleh faham? Okay, so since this is a what we call a pure breed, so kita tahu kita mesti guna B besar dan B besar. Kalau dia tak sebut pure breed, kita boleh guna B besar B kecil. Sebab apa? B besar B kecil pun boleh jadi purple, betul tak? Okay, so kalau awak tengok key kat sini pun dia dah bagi dah. B tu untuk dominant allele. So dominant allele, okay, will carry dominant trait. Trait dia apa? Purple. So kalau siapa ada B besar, mesti dia akan purple. Okay, so B kecil apa? B kecil adalah recessive allele. So siapa ada recessive allele, dua-dua dia akan jadi white. Okay, so boleh faham eh? Okay, so sekarang ni, okay, lepas phenotype, kita kena tulis parental genotype. Genotype tu yang kena ada dua-dua allele. So ini satu allele, ni dua allele. So sebab dia kan dia pure breed, so kita kena guna benda yang sama. So B besar, B besar. Okay, and then yang ni sebab dia white, so B besar, sorry, B kecil, B kecil. Okay, so this is what we call genotype. So genotype ni akan ada dalam sel, dalam sel manusia lah. So dia mesti buat meiosis, betul tak? Dia akan buat meiosis. So kalau awak tengok error ni, kita panah ni, menunjukkan this cell, it will undergo meiosis. So meiosis akan hasilkan apa? Akan hasilkan gamet. Gamet tu sama ada sperm ataupun ovum. Okay, sebagai contoh, ini ayah, ini ibu. So ayah ni akan hasilkan sperm. Ibu ni akan hasilkan ovum. So dalam ovum dengan sperm dia tu akan ada sama ada B besar, B besar ataupun B kecil, B kecil. So sebabkan ni sama, so kita buat satu je lah. Okay, so ini sperm, ini ovum. So sperm and ovum ni bila bertemu dia akan buat fertilization. Betul tak? Fertilization is the process where sperm and ovum meet each other to form what? To form zygote. Boleh faham? So ini F1. F1 ni maksudnya adalah offspring. F1 ni adalah offspring. Okay, kejap. Ni awak tengok ni. Bukan offspring, sorry. Filial generation. Filial generation. So F2 stand for filial generation. Okay, maksudnya offspring dia lah is the result of the mating between individual of pure breed of parenting. Maksudnya F1 tu filial generation lah. Ni awak tengok ni. Anak dia lah atau nama lain kita namakan sebagai anak. Okay, so F1 dia kalau awak perasan, dia akan ambil okay karakteristik daripada sperm dan juga ovum. So dia akan jadi B besar satu, B kecil satu. So kita tengok eh. So kalau B besar, B kecil, for sure they are all become purple. Sebab apa? Dia ada dominant allele. Dia ada dominant allele. Tapi cikgu dia ada recessive allele juga, ingat eh. Dominant allele will always be expressed over recessive allele. Sebab itulah in the end on the F1 phenotype dia akan jadi purple. Tapi dia carrier sebenarnya. Sebab apa dia carrier? Sebab dia bawa satu recessive allele. Okay. Okay, so based on what we call? Okay, based on pure breed. This is what we call pure breed. Yang bawah ni hybrid lah, sebab apa kita ambil result daripada pure breed tadi. So ni hybrid lah. Ingat tak ya hybrid tadi yang cikgu cerita? Ni hybrid. Hybrid is the product of mating between two pure breed variety. Okay, so ni breed lah. Hybrid lah. Okay, so kita ambil daripada anak dia ni, kita kacuk each other. So purple, purple.
So dia punya F1 genotype ni kan, mesti start dengan phenotype ni, phenotype ni, phenotype ni, selepas phenotype genotype. Okay, so genotype dia B besar B kecil. So the cell will undergo meiosis to produce gamete. So yang ni kita kena buat dua panah lah, anak panah lah. Sebab apa? Dia ada dua allele yang berbeza. Yang ni satu, sebab apa? Sebab dia ada allele yang sama. Okay, so B besar, B kecil. So this gamete will undergo fertilization. So ada empat possibility kat sini. So B1 dia akan bergabung dengan B besar ni dia akan gabung dengan B besar kat sini. So jadi B besar. Lepas tu So produk daripada purebred tu, okay, kita gunakan untuk next schematic diagram. So B besar. So dia akan undergo meiosis. Okay, bila dia undergo meiosis, okay, dia akan hasilkan gamete. So these are the possible gamete they will produce. Okay, awak kena ingat satu ni dia akan kasut dua kali. Sebab tu awak tengok panah dia ada dua. Ni pun sama juga dua kali. Yang ni pun dua kali. Itu maksimum dia. Okay, so B besar ni dia akan bergabung dengan B besar yang ni. Sebab tu lah tulis B besar. Lepas tu B besar ni dia akan bergabung dengan B kecil ni. So sebab tu lah B besar, B kecil. Yang ni pun sama. B kecil campur dengan B besar. Awak kena ingat walaupun yang ni start dulu, tapi kita kena sentiasa tulis B dominant allele dulu. B besar, B kecil. Yang ni pun sama. B kecil and B kecil. So this is what we call F2. Sebab tadi F1 kan, ni F2 lah sebab ini anak yang kedua. F2 filial, filial generation, okay, genotype. Okay, yang ni genotype dia lah sebab apa dia ada allele kan. Okay, lepas tu kita kena interpret apa phenotype dia. So yang ni purple, betul tak? Sebab apa purple? Sebab dua-dua adalah dominant allele. Yang ni pun purple sebab apa? Dia ada at least one dominant allele. Yang ni pun sama. Sebab apa? Sebab dia ada dominant allele. Tapi yang ni dia adalah white. Sebab apa? Dia tak ada dominant allele. Dia ni ada recessive allele. Okay, so dia akan jadi white. So this one it will produce 3 purple and 1 white. Tapi kalau first tadi pure breeding dia akan hasilkan semua purple. Kalau yang ni dia akan hasilkan 3 purple 1 white. Sebab itulah kalau awak terperasan dalam adik-beradik awak lah sebagai contoh. If you notice in within your sibling, ada yang tinggi, ada yang rendah, ada yang kulit putih, ada yang kulit gelap, ada yang kulit sedang-sedang. So this will tell you how the variation occur in your family. Even though kalau awak perasan lah sebagai contoh, awak tengok mak dan ayah awak dua-dua kulit gelap sebagai contoh. Contohlah mak ayah dan ayah dua-dua kulit gelap. Tapi tengok adik awak ni ada seorang kulit putih. Kenapa macam tu? Adakah dia nak pungut? Bukan. This is the way how you explain it. Satu lagi contoh. So, contohnya mak awak rambut lurus, ayah awak rambut kerinting. Tapi anak-anak dia semua rambut lurus. Semua rambut kerinting. Apa maksud ni? This is the way how you can tell. Okay? Okay, tengok sikit bio exploration ni. Based on mono hybrid cross, Mendel. Mendel ni scientist. Okay, scientist yang discover about schematic diagram. Okay? Okay, Mendel obtain phenotype 291 in F2 generation, which is close to the ratio 3:1. Okay, 291 ni is something else. Okay, yang ni kita akan belajar next tu. Tapi yang awak dah jumpa apa? 3:1, betul tak? 3 purple, 1 white. Okay dah. Yang ni pun samalah. Yang ni orang panggil Punnett square. Okay, so ada dua cara awak nak tunjukkan how it works. Sama ada you want to use schematic diagram or you want to use Punnett square. Okay, Punnett square pun boleh juga. Okay, sebagai contoh awak tengok Okay, parent dia ingat purebred mesti guna allele yang sama. B besar, B kecil. Okay, samalah allele yang sama. So, awak pecahkan. Ni mak dia kan. Contohnya ni mak dia. Sebab ni perempuan kan, ni lelaki. So, mak dia B besar. Apa aku ni? Betul lah. Ni nak tengok ni. B besar, darat dengan B besar, B kecil. Dia akan hasilkan semua B besar, B kecil.
Ingat eh, kalau awak buat schematic diagram ataupun Punnett square, awak kena buat sampai F2. Kena buat sampai F2 baru awak complete. Kalau tak boleh berhenti sini saja, okey. Sebab apa? Yang ni akan ambil half daripada mak, half daripada ayah. So dia akan hasilkan benda yang sama lah, lebih besar, besar kecil. And then we want to use hybrid, right? Hybrid tu maksudnya produk daripada purebred tu kita guna. So B besar, B kecil, darab dengan B besar, B kecil. So B besar, B kecil, B besar, B kecil. So kita gabungkan lah. B besar, campur B besar, B besar, B besar. Okay, B besar, darab dengan B kecil, B besar, B kecil. Lepas tu B besar darab dengan B kecil, B besar, B kecil. Yang ni pun sama. So awak tengok ada 3 purple, 1 white, sama saja. Tapi dalam exam usually dia akan suruh buat schematic diagram lah, because this is a very famous question. Okay, okay guys, yang tadi saya cerita pasal Mendel kan. Mendel is the scientist, scientist yang discover pasal benda ni. So this Mendel, okay, Mendel tu nama dia eh. Mendel produced 2 law. Dia menghasilkan 2 law, okay. This is the first law. First law ni untuk monohybrid. Monohybrid maksudnya kita kaji pasal satu karakteristik saja, iaitu pasal tadi kita belajar pasal color, betul tak? Okay, kita tengok sikit. Mendel first law ni dia cakap apa? Okay, Mendel produce Mendel first law or law of segregation. Okay, so ada nama, 2 nama lah. Okay, dia hasilkan Mendel first law dan juga law of S. Susah nak sebut, cikgu sebut S je lah eh. Apa yang dia cakap? A characteristic of an organism is controlled by a pair of allele. Betul tak? A pair of allele. Allele tu tak boleh, allele tu sama ada T besar ataupun T kecil. Dia must be pair. Maksudnya pair T besar, T besar, T besar, T kecil, T kecil, T kecil. So the characteristic of organism is controlled by that lah. Kalau awak ada a pair of allele that T besar, T besar, so awak akan jadi tinggi. Kalau awak ada T kecil, T kecil, maksudnya awak adalah rendah. Okay, and only one of allele pair is inherited in the gamet. So maksudnya hanya satu allele saja yang akan diwarisi dalam satu gamet. Okay, apa maksud dia ni? Awak tengok ni. So bila dia buat meiosis ni, satu je lah kan allele yang akan dihasilkan. Contohlah ini daripada ayah dia kan. Sperm kan ada berjuta. So dalam berjuta sperm tu hanya ada 2 possibility. Sama ada dia bawa B besar, B kecil. B besar atau B kecil. So tengoklah contohlah sperm tu dia, sperm yang paling kuat dia bawa B kecil. So awak akan jadi white. Possibility awak untuk jadi white lah, tak jadi purple lah. Faham maksud cikgu? Okay, so maksudnya ovum pun samalah, ada possibility sama ada dia bawa B besar ataupun B kecil. Okay, so this is the summary of Mendel monohybrid experiment. Okay, sebab ni first law kan. First law dia kaji satu karakteristik, sebab itulah dia mono. Okay, nombor satu dia cakap apa? Characteristic inherited from parents to the next generation is determined by genetic factor which is known as a gene. Okay, a trait that is controlled by a pair of genetic factor is known as a allele. Okay, a pair of allele segregate randomly. Segregate ni maksudnya terpisah. Segregate tu maksudnya terpisah. Awak tengok ni. Allele ni bersama kan, betul tak? Tapi after meiosis dia akan berpisah jadi 2. Sama ada dia akan jadi B besar saja ataupun B kecil saja. Itu maksud dia. A pair of allele separate randomly during formation of gamete. And only one allele from a pair is found in a single gamete. Maksudnya dalam gamete, dalam sperm, satu saja dia akan bawa, sama ada B besar ataupun B kecil. Dalam ovum pun sama, dia akan bawa sama ada B besar ataupun B kecil. Okay, during fertilization, a zygote form possesses 2 allele. One from parents, satu daripada ayah, satu daripada mak. Okay, contohnya awak tengok sini. Ni bila dia kacut, satu daripada ayah, satu daripada mak. Satu daripada ayah, satu daripada mak. Okay. Okay, fertilization is random. Random maksudnya, can we choose which sperm to fertilize with ovum? Tak boleh kan? Maksudnya benda ni akan berlaku secara random. Okay, genotype combination which is homozygous dominant. Homozygous dominant maksudnya T besar, T besar. Kenapa homo? Sebab dia sama. Kenapa dominant? Sebab dia T besar. Okay, homozygous dominant show dominant trait. Betul lah, sebab dia akan show contohnya B besar, trait dia adalah besar. Dominant trait dia besar, betul tak? Kalau homozygous recessive, dia kecil. Sebab apa? Dia ada B kecil, B kecil.
Tapi kalau heterozygous, it's a combination of one dominant allele and one recessive allele. Ni contohnya ni lah. Ni orang panggil hot heterozygous. Yang ni orang panggil homozygous dominant. Ni homozygous recessive. Yang ni heterozygous. Sebab apa? Dia ada one dominant allele, one recessive allele. Lalu lah Jesse Lowry ni. Kita biar dia berlalu dulu eh. Okay, boleh faham? So heterozygous will show dominant trait. Sebab apa? Dia ada dominant allele. Dominant allele will always be expressed over recessive allele. Okay, boleh faham? Seterusnya kita akan belajar dihybrid. Tadi kita belajar monohybrid. Monohybrid maksudnya satu karakteristik. Tapi kalau yang ni kita di maksudnya dua. Karakteristik dua yang kita akan belajar. Pertama sekali kalau kat sini dia cakap round and yellow. Yang ni constrict dan juga green. So mesti kita belajar karakteristik pertama adalah pasal warna. Betul tak? Obviously. Yang kedua adalah the structure of the shape of the seed. So karakteristik dia dua lah. Pertama sekali adalah shape of the seed and also the color of the seed. Okay. Okay guys, so let's continue. Okay, just now we have studied about monohybrid inheritance. Now we are going to proceed with dihybrid inheritance. Okay, so this is the definition. Dihybrid inheritance involve inheritance of two characteristic. Okay, each characteristic are controlled by a different gene located at different locus. Okay, so as you can see in this schematic diagram. Ingat eh, nama ni adalah schematic diagram. Okay, so this schematic diagram show to you about dihybrid inheritance. Why? Because we are studying two characteristic. Okay, the first characteristic is about the condition of the seed. Either it is round or constrict. Kalau round ni dia bulat lah. Kalau constrict ni dia berkedut sikit. Okay, and the next characteristic is about dia color. It's either yellow or green. So first thing that you should know is that what's are dominant and what's are recessive. So they give you the key already. Okay, so remember untuk round seed. Okay, round seed ni dia dominant. Sebab apa? Dia guna capital letter. Allele lah. So this is allele, dominant allele. So this is recessive allele. Okay, so recessive allele, okay, is for recessive trait. Trait dia adalah constrict seed lah. Okay, so this is the first characteristic. Okay, the next characteristic is about the color. So kalau dia K huruf besar, dia adalah dominant. Okay, dominant allele for yellow seed. So warna yellow ni adalah dominant lah. Okay, warna hijau ni adalah recessive. Okay, so this is, let's go. Okay guys. Okay, so schematic diagram. Okay, so remember we should always start with purebred. Purebred maksudnya the allele must be identical. Kalau B besar, mesti B besar juga. Kalau K besar, mesti K besar juga. Okay, so if you notice here, we have B besar, K besar, K besar. B kecil, K kecil. Okay, so we should begin with parental phenotype. Phenotype tu is the physical characteristic. So it is round and yellow. Yang ni constrict and green. So their parental genotypes are B besar, K besar. So ni pun sama. B kecil, K kecil. So this cell, okay, it will undergo meiosis to produce gamete. Okay, so it will produce BK. Yang ni B besar, K besar. Yang ni B kecil, K kecil. So this gamete, okay, they will fuse to each other and that process is known as a fertilization. So this is F1, filial kan? Filial genotype. So it will produce, remember this is how you arrange them. So B, the next to it must be B as well. So B besar, B kecil. K besar, K kecil. Okay. So in the end, you should interpret, okay, based on the genotype, awak kena interpret apa genotype dia. So kalau B besar, B kecil, mesti dia round. Sebab apa? Sebab B besar is the dominant allele. Dominant allele will always be expressed over recessive allele. So dia takkan jadi constrict lah, dia akan jadi round. Okay, yang ni K besar, K kecil. So kita ada dominant allele. So K besar is for dominant allele, which is yellow seed. So that's why for F1 phenotype, all will be round and yellow. Okay. Lepas tu, we do cross, self-cross. Maksudnya, daripada produk, daripada F1 ni, kita kacuk each other. Okay. So, same here, you should start with F1 phenotype. So, yang ni round and yellow seed. Yang ni pun samalah. So dia punya genotype pun must be the same lah. B besar, B kecil, K besar, K kecil. Ha, ni pun sama. B besar, B kecil, K besar, K kecil. So they are all are going to undergo meiosis. So the first possibility is B besar, K besar ni. Yang ni ingat dia dua kali B besar dengan K besar. Lepas tu B besar dengan K kecil. Awak tengok. Lepas tu B kecil, K besar. B kecil, K kecil. So this is the possibility of the gamete that will be produced. Same goes here. Sebab ni sama kan. So B besar, B besar, B besar, B ke, K kecil, B kecil, K besar, B kecil, B kecil. Okay, during the formation of gamete, any allele from the seed shape can pair with any allele from seed color. So we know that gamete will fuse each other randomly. So kita tak boleh pilih lah, dia berlaku secara random. So what will happen? This is what will happen. Okay guys, remember untuk dihybrid inheritance, you should end with Punnett square. Maksudnya awak kena gabungkan schematic dengan Punnett square. Tapi kalau monohybrid, it's fine if you use schematic diagram only. Sebab apa? Kalau dihybrid ni dia banyak. Bila banyak awak kena guna dua-dua. Okay, so this is how you put it. So ini gamete yang pertama. B besar, B K besar. B besar, K kecil. B kecil, K besar. B kecil, K kecil. So sama juga kat sini. So awak cuma gabungkan sahaja. So B besar, okay contohlah yang ni cikgu gabungkan yang ni. B besar campur B besar. Betul tak? B besar, B besar. K besar campur K besar. So B besar, B besar. So same goes here. Okay, awak gabungkan sampailah kat sini. Okay, sampailah dekat sini. So once you get it, you have to interpret what is their phenotype. Kalau ini contohlah cikgu ambil yang ni. Yang ni round dan juga yellow. Sebab apa? Dia ada dua-dua dominant allele. Yang ni pun sama. Dia ada dua-dua dominant allele. Tapi yang ni dia B kecil, B kecil, K kecil, K kecil. Ingat kalau tak ada dominant allele, nak tak nak kena express juga dalam bentuk recessive. So ini constrict dan juga kering. So after you match them, this is the result. Phenotype ratio for F2 generation. So kita ada 9 yellow, 9 round and yellow. Okay, kita ada 3 round and green seed. Kita ada 3 constrict and yellow. And 1 constrict and green seed. Okay, so this is the product. Basically dalam enzyme dia akan tanya awak, state the ratio for for dihybrid inheritance. So jawapan awak lah 9.3.3.1. Okay. Okay, since we are studying about inheritance, we should use Mendel law. Tapi kalau kat sini kita study pasal dihybrid, right? So dihybrid dia akan guna Mendel second law. Macam tadi mono dia guna first law. Kalau di dia guna second. So apa yang terjadi? Mendel introduce Mendel second law, which is known as a law of independent assortment. Nama lain dia lah. We state during gamete formation, Okay, each allele from a pair of allele can combine randomly with any allele from another pair of allele. So maksudnya yang ni dengan yang ni, it will occur randomly. It will occur randomly, but this is the possibility. Ni possibility dia, tapi dia nak bergabung dengan yang ni ke, dia nak bergabung dengan yang ni ke, ikut dia punya suka. So itu maksudnya random lah. Okay. So apa summary daripada Mendel dihybrid experiment? Apa yang dicakap? A new combination of characteristic are produced in F2 generation. Betul lah? Ni a new one kan? Kita ada round and yellow, kita ada round and green, constrict and yellow. So many variation there. Okay, namely constrict yellow seed and round green seed. Okay. Lepas tu two characteristic, seed shape and color are combined in F1 generation, but later they are separated, okay, and react freely, okay, freely. Maksudnya dia akan react, maksudnya dia akan combine secara random lah, freely, okay, during F2, okay. Okay guys, so I think that's all for today. If you have any question, okay, please ask me, okay, OPM personally. Okay, so once you done watching this video, please write down your name and class on comment section, and please try to complete, okay, the exercise I have given to you, okay, through the Telegram. Okay, on Friday we are going to discuss together, okay, through Google Meet. Okay, I think that's all for today. So I see you next class. Assalamualaikum. Bye bye.